Hello everyone, today we're going to be making a hair bow to use with my handmade clay topper. I made this clay topper myself and I even printed the pattern on her dress and decoupaged that on. I will do a tutorial on how to print your own decoupage patterns as well later on, so keep an eye on my channel for that and I will do one of those tutorials soon. But today we are going to be making this bow, which is known as the tulip style hair bow. And to make this bow, I've got this lovely ribbon. I got this from AliExpress. I will link everything that I've used in the description below this video, so you can check all of these out. And this ribbon is a lovely, like, sort of canvassy fabric, I would say. It has got a good stiffness to it, so it will hold a really nice shape in any hair bow style. And it is also double-sided, so I'm loving this. You can actually see that on this side, it's got some white in the pattern on the edges, whereas on this side, it's got a black edging. So I would say it goes this way up, but because it's double-sided, if you make a bow where the front and the back show, this is a brilliant ribbon to have. So I've cut 5 pieces of ribbon. This longer piece is for the base bow, and then these 4 pieces are all that cut to the same length for the main part of the bow. And all 4 pieces are 1.5 inch wide or 4 centimeter wide. And all 4 pieces are cut to 27 centimeters in length or 10.5 inches in length. And I've chosen 2 in the houndstooth pattern and 2 black. You can use any patterns and any colours from your pattern you can pick out. And then for the base bow, I've got 1 piece again. I've chosen black. And this is 4 centimeters wide, 1.5 inch wide. And for the base bow, this is cut to 40 centimeters in length, or 15¾ inches in length. I've got a couple of clips here and a couple of pins. So first of all, you need to take a lighter and you need to heat seal all of the ends of your ribbons to prevent fraying. And then taking one of your pattern pieces and one of your plain, you can put them together. And then we're going to fold it in half to find the center. Grabbing a pin, I'm going to pop a pin in there and that will hold those 2 pieces together and also mark that halfway point. I'm going to do the same with the other 2 pieces. So popping them both together, fold them in half. Popping a pin on the halfway mark. So they look like this. Then taking one of the pieces of ribbon, which are now joined together, the 2 pieces, I'm going to turn it so the pattern is facing away from me, and I'm going to bring this right side and fold it down diagonally so that this edge is in line with this center pin. And then I'm going to get the left side and I'm going to fold this piece backwards and down so they're in line down the middle, and you've got this point at the top where this central pin is. So it looks like this. And this is what the back looks like. And then taking this left side where this plain piece of pattern or the folded piece here is showing, you want to bring those pieces and cross them over diagonally over the right side. So bringing the left side over the right so they cross over like this. And then we're going to bring these inner corners and fold them up to meet with this point. So I'm going to take this top piece first and I'm going to fold it upwards so this inner corner meets the point at the top. And then the same with this other piece. Bring it up so the inner corners meet that point. So this is what the back looks like. This is the front. And then I've just got my clips here. I'm going to pop a clip across that top to hold those all in place, like that. And then we're going to do the same with the other piece, exactly the same steps. We've now got two pieces that look the same, and now we're ready to stitch across that raw edge and form the pinch. So I've got some extra strong thread here threaded on my needle with a knot in the end. Taking one of my halves, I'm going to do 6 stitches on each side, so 12 altogether. So we're going to go in through the first corner for our first stitch. 1. 2, 3, 4. I'm just going to keep this pinched in place whilst I remove the clip so you can see where I'm stitching. 5. The 6th one is going to come through this half of the point and catch this last corner. 6. Now we're going to basically mirror those 6 stitches on this other half. So just making sure we've got that point and that they're lined up. We're going to go back through this half, catching the bottom corners. So that's 7. 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So this is what it looks like. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12 stitches. And then I'm going to remove that pin and pull this tight, and that will form the pinch across that bottom. And then once you've got that pulled nice and tight, go through that last edge. And before you pull it completely tight, go through that loose loop a couple of times, and that will form a knot to hold the pinch all in place. So it looks like this. And then we can trim off the excess thread and repeat those same steps with the other half. So we've got our two halves now sewn with the pinches in the bottom, and these are ready to join together. So whilst my hot glue gun is warming up, I'm going to make my base bow. So taking the 40 centimetre piece of ribbon, I'm just going to heat seal the ends just so they don't fray whilst I'm working on my base bow. But we will trim these at the end anyway. So to make the base bow, bring one half down diagonally like that and the other half up diagonally. So you've got this S sort of shape. Line those two pieces up and you want about a 1.5 centimetre overlap on each end. And you can also measure that against your bow. So if they were together, they would sit perfectly on the top of there. And then again, taking my clips, I'm just going to clip those ends into place. So it looks like this. And then I'm going to fold this in half. To find the centre, I'm going to use a little bit of heat from a lighter to mark a crease in there. And that will give me a guide as to where I need to do my sewing. So again, taking a needle, threaded with some strong thread and a knot in the end, we can now do our stitches through this middle. You could do 6 on either side or 4 on either side. It don't matter too much as a base bow. I'll go for 6 because as a rule, with 4 centimetre wide ribbon, I generally do 6 stitches across there. So that is 6 for that side. 6 stitches on the other side. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So it looks like this. Remove both of the clips and then you can pull that pinch in there. Wrap around the centre a couple of times to hold it all in place. And then I'm just going to go through the underside. And before I pull it completely tight, I'll just go through that loop to form a knot so I can trim off the excess thread. So you've got a single pinwheel bow for the base bow. And then we're ready to put all of these together. So now my hot glue gun is warmed up. I'm going to join the two halves of the main bow together first. Like that. And then we're going to join that onto the base bow. I'm just going to pop a bit of glue across that join. And then lay that on my base bow. So that the middle bit here is central to the bow. And then we're going to cut the tails down and give them some shape. So I like to cut slightly rounded. So from this outer corner, I'm going to cut diagonally and slightly rounded, and I'm going to do the same with the other half. So from this outer corner, diagonally and slightly rounded. So it looks like that. And then again, heat seal those raw edges. And then we're ready to add our clip and our strip around the centre. So taking a clip, this one is 65 millimetres or 2.5 inches in length, and that is just a nice size for this bow. The actual finished bow, by the way, is 5 inches or around 13 centimetres across from the tails included. So 65 millimeter clip, and taking a 1 centimeter wide ribbon in black to match my bow, I'm going to line my clip. So I'm going to heat seal the raw end, place some hot glue around a couple of inches along that end, placing it on the underside of the clip around 1.5 centimeters along that pinch part. And then I'm going to tuck it inside of the pinch part like that, and then we're going to take it across the top of the clip. So placing the hot glue along the top of the clip, and then I'm going to trim off where it meets the edge of that ribbon. So this will be enough to line the rest of it, but I'm not going to do that yet. I'm going to leave this piece loose for now. I'm going to stick this on the underside of my bow. So across the middle of the bow. And then again, taking the 1 centimeter wide ribbon in the black, I'm going to wrap a piece around the center. So again, heat seal that raw edge, a little piece of glue on the underside. I'm going to start on the top so I can make sure I cover the join, because my clay topper is going to go on there, so you won't see the top of the bow anyway. And then I'm just going to start wrapping around that center. Going to pop another touch of glue on that first piece round to make sure that keeps in place and it doesn't slide. I'm going to go around for a second time. And then finish off on the underside this time. Heat seal that raw edge. Glue that last edge down under the clip. And then at this point we can finish it off with this piece, and that will cover that center strip and also give the bow extra security so it can last for many, many years. So as you can see, by lining the clip and covering that center strip, that just gives a really nice professional finish on there. Now we're going to add our gorgeous handmade clay doll. Now to add clay dolls, super glue works really well, but also hot glue and felt work really well. So as my clay doll is only small, I'm just going to use my Gorilla Super Glue gel today. So I'm just going to figure out what parts of the clay doll is going to touch my bow. So around the middle, the bottom of her hair, down to around the middle of her dress. So I'm going to place my glue around the bottom of her hair, bottom of her dress. And this glue is a gel consistency, so it's really nice and thick. I do like this glue. And then I'm going to place that on my bow centrally, and I am just going to hold her there for a minute or so just to make sure that it's set enough to let go. And there you have your finished tulip style hair bow with handmade clay doll. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. If you did, please hit the like button. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel and press the bell button to turn on notifications. Thanks for watching, everyone. Bye.